This is the FA Cup final. The team's line for the national anthem. The vocalists here, formerly street singers in the Cafe Society of Covent Garden, Rebecca Knight and Karen England, from busking to basking in the attention of a worldwide audience at the FA Cup Final 2001. The presentation party headed by the Duke of York, the president of the Football Association, Geoff Thompson, the chairman of the FA. Crozier, the FA chief executive, who's been making his own headlines over the past week. Liverpool, a very good season, can become brilliant over the next 8 days. The Worthington Cup carried off here in Cardiff.
Back at home, that this is coming through. Why the Millennium Stadium? A lot was asked, and I asked the question myself. I now know. This is an atmosphere that, in 10 years sitting beside you, Mr. Tyler, I haven't witnessed.
Well, the Football Association has a three-year contract with the Millennium Stadium, an extra two-year option on top of that. But it's also fair to say the FA are scrutinising every aspect of this occasion. But so far, so good. Liverpool lost the toss for choice of kit, but for the superstitious, Arsenal did not wear red and white in either 1950 or 1971 when they beat Liverpool at Wembley. And no club has ever beaten the same club three times in the final of the FA Cup. Maybe Arsenal will become the first today. Gerard Houllier and his men will have other ideas. An all-English defensive unit, goalkeeper and back four, three of them in their third FA Cup final, Seaman, Dixon and Adams, Martin Keown in his second, and a first for Ashley Cole. Real competition for places in midfield. Vieira, a certainty, and Pires. Freddie Ljungberg has forced himself into the picture with recent goals. The quartet completed by Gilles Grimondi. And it's the French strike force of Thierry Henry and Sylvain Wiltord. While Gerard Houllier's selection system has hardly rotated come the crunch, goalkeeper and back four, undeniable first choices. But key decisions in midfield, Danny Murphy and Vladimir Schmitzer in. And down to the bench, Patrick Berger and Gary McAllister. Up front, 43 goals between them, Heskey and Owen. Robbie Fowler left champing at the bit on the bench.
Well, for the last week, people have debated and debated what's going to separate these two teams, Martin. I'm not so sure what is going to separate them, but the systems are similar in the extreme. That, a vastly experienced defensive unit, with the exception, obviously, of Ashley Cole. But the other four, Seaman, Dixon, Keown, Adam, will play today as if it's their last appearance in an FA Cup final, no doubt about that. And they will have to play well. They will defend deep, both defences. In midfield, there'll be similarities. Grimondi, I'm sure, will be the one who says, I'll hold, I'll sit. Ljungberg's natural rotation to go forward. So is Pires, and Vieira will as well. And then with the front two, the pace and the power, the threat of Wiltord and Henry. For Liverpool, it's almost exactly the same. A strong and comfortable back four that know each other and play well together. Will defend deep, I'm sure. In midfield, the talent is there. Haman will sit, the other three will tuck in slightly ahead of him and try and go forward. And there it is in front of you. No Fowler. His record against Arsenal is incredible. But Heskey and Owen have been given the nod. They have what it takes. Can they do it today?
Kickoff. Respect paid for the loss of life at a football match recently in Ghana. Sponsored FA Cup has had to fight for its prominence in recent times, but what a fight it's put up this season. Numerous non-league successes, Tranmere Rovers, that classic comeback against Southampton. What about the wonders of Wycombe Wanderers, who were so nearly playing here at Cardiff today? And now we have two tremendously talented teams out to give an excellent FA Cup campaign a classy climax.
We're in a vintage competition, Martin. I just hope we get a vintage final. The ingredients are there. The mix is there. The atmosphere's here. Ryan Rocastle. Wonderful moment. Nice touch from Arsenal. The huddle. The business end now.
Well, for those of you with us on Sky Digital and our interactive facilities, the player cam starts focusing on Thierry Henry. Arsenal very much hoping he will be at the sharp end of events in Cardiff today. So here we go. Here's Patrick Vieira.
Just looking quickly, Martin, with McAllister being left on the bench, Gary McAllister and Danny Murphy in. Often they played Murphy infield, Gerrard just right of him. But I think such is the respect that Gerard Houllier has for Patrick Vieira. And he's put Gerrard infield, Murphy on the right side.
Lee Dixon didn't train yesterday, that's just a precaution for Arsenal. Here's the other right back, Marcus Babbel, but he's caught in possession by Pires. Henry. Pires again, one of five Frenchmen in this Arsenal lineup. Five Englishmen as well, five Englishmen for Liverpool too.
Nice break. Early in the match, but the pass was a sound one. Pitch did look a little slow, Martin. The ball didn't really travel quickly over it for Robert Pires.
Travelling forward for Arsenal, Martin Keown. He's gone right on the line. Adams up there as well, around the penalty spot. Just going a bit deeper. Vestergaard comes, and that will be a great start for Liverpool's Dutch goalkeeper.
Well, if he has got a weakness, Sander Vestergaard, I do feel it with cross balls at times. He's not as assured as he might be.
Murphy. Looking it over Dixon, where Michael Owen, who's on such a splendid streak of form, and he takes on Dixon, and he went to cut it back, Adams knocked it away.
Lack of support, really, the only thing it was lacking there.
Emil Heskey shaping to make himself available if Carragher can get the length in the throw. Let's go towards Heskey. Keown's on duty there. The heat will certainly be a factor. It's very, very warm on that far side of the pitch in the sunshine. It'll be baking on the bench. Gerrard. Andy, he had to be switched to play centrally during the league game against Chelsea in midweek. He didn't get very far. Played wide by Gerrard to Marcus Babbel.
He's getting a touchdown really at the moment, Martin. It's every player. I don't care how experienced you are, we'll be feeling the touch in there today.
Rowe won a touch of the ball early in the match, and a sure touch at that.
Ljungberg. Here's Henri, passed on shot. Scooped on the referee, prepared to play an advantage then. There was a bit of contact on Thierry Henri, but he wanted to go on. The referee read the situation very well.
Well, there's two examples. First Michael Owen and then Thierry Henri, both showing that they have the pace and the ability to expose the defenders on either side. But much like Michael Owen, just like a little support, Henri.
David Seaman, 37, is the 10th oldest player to play in an FA Cup final, as far as the records will show. Even the oldest Arsenal goalkeeper, because George Swindon was older when he played in the 50s. Testimonial match to come against Barcelona. We'll have to have the FA Cup on display for that at Highbury later this month. Another 37-year-old. Tenth time the FA Cup has brought them together. Four Liverpool successes down the years, all at Arsenal, strangely. Five times Arsenal have come out on top, three times on their way to Wembley, and twice, as you've been hearing all day, at Wembley. Foul by Dixon, quick free kick by Gerrard, catching Schmeitzer offside.
It's interesting to see if Arsenal do that, hold the line, held it well there. It is a dangerous policy when you're playing against the likes of Owen and Heskey-Martin, and Liverpool again sitting almost, well, contrary to what everyone believes about dropping off, we'll hold a little line up and let you run in there. But you have to get it right.
He's looking for any early scars on the pitch.
Yep.
Been protected, of course, since it was relayed. This pallet system, 7,500 squares of grass, brought into place 10 days ago, bedded in. The weather's been kind in that respect. Certainly kind to the spectators today, but maybe not to the players. Murphy. Anshaw. Adam's just giving a little instruction there to Cole, who obeyed it and then was in a position to clear. Touched off by Henri. Wiltord has had so many successful moments in this season's FA Cup. Half a dozen goals, but there's a cameo of Steven Gerrard. With a wonderful reclaiming tackle.
That's why the switch has been made. No doubt in my mind about that, Mark. I think if there's one thing both teams are guilty of at times, they get a little narrow high up the pitch. I don't think Schmeitzer, Ljungberg, Perez and Murphy provide an awful lot of width the majority of the times. They get a touch now on both sides.
Perez. We've got the winner in the semi-final. Pierre Perez has continued his run, with Wiltord had gone to the left and was available but not spotted. Carragher. A real success story for Liverpool this season, in a role that he doesn't really relish, but he's happy to do for the collective good at left-back. Problem position for Gerard Houllier prior to that. Heskey. Using his strength. Oh, and Grimondi pulled his arms away to make sure that the referee realised that Grimondi believed there was no contact.
Nothing in it for me either.
This is Owen. Owen and Heskey looking to take Arsenal on at the back.
Well, what was promising from Emil Heskey, Adams chased him back, but he brushed the big man off and forced his way past him. A little bit easier than I would have expected against Tony Adams. So no McAllister to deliver that accurate dead ball.
And, Danny Murphy looking back on a season where he scored a wonderful set-piece goal to win the day at Old Trafford for Liverpool. Big ball delivery from him. Schmeitzer coming in behind Babel. who's right back position now and needs some covering, because it's Ori for Arsenal. Plenty on the gallop from Arsenal's midfield as well. Wiltor. Carragher is the defender. And a very good defender. But Schmeitzer didn't complete the job really, and Carragher won't be too impressed with that.
Half a chance, a good situation. Breaking quickly like that, Arsenal with plenty of players in support. I don't think they made the most of that.
Dixon again, heading beyond Schmeitzer. Our man has to have a swipe at it, but connected cleanly. It's a strange piece of retrieving for Liverpool. And back in bother. Adams and Keown against Heskey. Slows. Gerrard on the sprint, but left the foot in.
I think it was a ball ready to be contested. I think Marcus Barrow's got the right to run it. It's just fractionally late. That's the only thing we'll see here. Again, the depth that Adams gives himself is the important thing here. The free kick's always going to be given after Tony's won this. The right leg, left trailing by Marcus Babbel. We talked about the heat. I'm lacking a bit in the hair department, like myself, Mr. McAllister, shielding it.
And hiding his disappointment as well, absolutely. Liverpool players were only told the team at around 1 o'clock today, so they were at the stadium still with that news, a resounding good news for some, not for others. Robbie Fowler looked very disappointed. Pires. Still Pires got the run of the ball against Palmer. Looking for Dixon, who gets to it. Cleared by Herpia, who sprang here for the third time. Played here, of course, in the Worthington Cup. And for Finland, who are the first opponents for Wales in the opening football match at this stadium that, of course, was rebuilt. The first goal scorer here is with Liverpool today, but not in the 16, Jari Litmanen. I just wonder if the bonus of familiarity with the stadium will be a factor, and the feel-good factor, of course, that those with winning a cup here already for Liverpool. That one, that final against the gallant Birmingham. Really went the distance to the penalty shootout.
Absolutely. I don't think I'll give them any advantage, Martin. I think what might do is the belief that they can win the game. The record against Arsenal, as you've already told us, is fantastic. That may be more of a factor than actually playing here. All those Arsenal, these Arsenal players are used to playing in big arenas and big occasions. Not new to them.
Murphy coming in to link up in the centre with Gerrard.
It's when it all gets a little narrow at times.
It's almost as if Hammond's won and then they've got three
ahead. It's what they do, and what Arsenal will be happy to do is concede a little bit of ground wide. I think they'll be saying, OK, if Murphy and Sweets will get wide and knock crosses in, I think Keown and Adams will be happy to deal with that. But what they don't want to do is get split and spread across the pitch and then passes are played in between them. Into the runs of Heskey and Owen.
Murphy. Pierre. Henri. Pires, who's seeing a good bit of the ball early on, and maybe that's why Didi Hamann's come across to make a point with that challenge. Harman has played in an FA Cup final before, not happy memories, in 99 Newcastle. He got an injury early on, was taken off at half-time. probably asked to come off at half-time, as the story goes, and the manager, Ruud Gullit, wasn't too impressed with that. But he's certainly out there for Liverpool today, and he's a key component in Gerard Houllier's strategy. Forward by Keogh. Murphy. Plenty of height. Needed some help forward and got it for Liverpool from Carragher. Vieira.
Arsenal started slightly better, Martin, the first 15 minutes were approaching. I think the use of the ball has been a bit better. We've controlled it a bit better. Pitch is slow, it looks to me. Doesn't look like the ball flows across it as sharply as it might do, as quickly as it might do.
We had some water put on it early this morning, but maybe it needed more. Cole. Pires. Closing down well. Both sides have almost underplayed the occasion, really. They've got matches next week, of course. Arsenal play in the Premiership. Still need one more point to be sure of second place. So there's no banquet tonight, no celebration plan. And after the league season comes to an end, and Liverpool, of course, they've got today over with, we'll be thinking about another cup final. Dortmund against Alaves of Spain for the UEFA Cup. Competition that Arsenal got to the final in last season, of course.
Well, we just saw a little cameo of what Didier Hamann does on this side as well when they don't have the ball. Arsenal looking to play it at the Henry. He almost tries to get himself in line with the ball and Thierry Henry, and he puts himself in that position, and if anybody plays a sloppy ball or a black ball, and he's there to intercept it.
It's a free kick in favour of Carragher on the far side. The untidy challenge by Wiltor. Anshaw. Headed by Cole. Time for Vieira. Time for him to stumble on the ball as well and still keep Arsenal in possession. Dixon. He probably preferred the Arsenal team to be playing the other way in the first half. The right back's in the shade. Gerrard.
There's the space. Tiquinho in there, Martin. There was no thought of stepping up. There was no thought of holding the line. He got deep very quickly. He gave himself a 5-yard start. He said, I'll deal with it then.
Cam fans, and I know there are many of you. Steven Gerrard now is under the focus for Sky Digital viewers, channel 404. If you want to listen to our celebrity fan zone, football fan zone, if you like, Roy Evans and Frank McClintock are giving their views on the game.
I hope they don't end up scrapping those two, Mark.
Take care, believe you me. And so do many millions of others. Here's Ljungberg. Dixon. Cole. Here is outside it. Mr. Cole now of Arsenal and England, of course. The young man alongside the old stages at the back for the Gunners, but it's in midfield that Arsenal win it. And the ball through to Thierry Henry was from Ljungberg. And Henry, oh, he says there was a hand.
Well, he's a hand from the linesman if there is, but I tell you what, you don't get many better chances than this. He's convinced there's an arm here, there's a handball. Brilliant pressure from Vieira in midfield, and this is a superb ball and a wonderful run. He goes a little wide, he looks to play it in himself. But does it hit the arm and go wide? It hits something, Martin, but what is it? The arm? It is. That's
Stefan
a penalty.
Arsho's left arm.
I'm sorry, I know it's not deliberate maybe, but that stops a goal. And in my book, that's a penalty. That's out of jail.
Owen. Murphy. Vieira, who was right side at the start of the season, sent off by Steve Dunn at Sunderland.
Well, that's the first tackle of the match. I'd be really surprised if it's anything other than a warning. To be fair, he's done the right thing, the referee. Quick word with Vieira, that's enough, that's sufficient.
Assistant on the far side, sun in the eyes, maybe.
Well, that's when you have to assist, Martin, I'm afraid. He had the best view in the ground of it. Totally unobstructed, no players in his way.
Henry denied by that. He's on the ball here.
They've been the best side. I said they started the break, they certainly have. The lads in the studio were talking about Liverpool being a counter-attack side. That's the way the game's panned out at the moment.
Well, here they come, and it was Gerrard who won the ball to set up the counter-attack. Oh, and he's got Heskey in the centre. Tony Adams used not every minute of his years of experience there to head off Michael Owen.
Well, that's what Owen would have wanted. They'd have planned for situations like this, you know. 1v1 against Tony Adams. Has he got the patience? Pop it round him and get past him. That's experience you see there. Total experience.
Harman. Cole. There's no doubt the talking point of the opening 20 minutes. Stefan Anschau preventing Arsenal and Thierry Henry taking the lead with his left arm.
Think of the consequence of the penalty being given as well, Mark. Not just possibly a goal, but sending off.
Owen, after Heskey had had a good touch. Gerrard! Brand new make of football today, new design. Aerodynamics put to the test here.
Well, they tell us it can go at 114 miles an hour. This one up there pushing it. Lovely strike, just rising as he hits it, not really threatening the goal. Restricts it well enough. Martin Keown was sufficiently worried to try and deflect it.
Dixon. Ljungberg, who put Henry in the clear with a beautifully weighted pass, the pass of the match so far.
It's very much a cautious approach from Liverpool, Martin. They're dropping off the play, they're allowing Arsenal to have it until they come into their own half. Very much the policy they adopted in Europe an awful lot.
Henry, Wiltor. Dixon has seen plenty of the ball in the Liverpool half. Wiltor has lost the ball in the Liverpool half here. Oh, not to get it back, he stuck out a foot there, and that could have deflected to Pires. It off, and here's Murphy. Babel. Now Anschau. Well spotted by Vieira. Good pressure on him for Liverpool by Heskey, and Harman to Murphy. And that threw off Tony Adams, as I think it did. It's a corner for Liverpool.
Ambitious effort. They need a bit of pressure, they need a bit of possession, Liverpool.
Halfway through the first half. Danny Murphy to take the corner. He raises his arms in the signal as the Seaman reacts likewise in the Arsenal goal. Adams, but Arsenal pulled everyone back, so there's no challenge here on Anschau. Well spotted by Dixon. And Carragher has to play it back to Vesterveld. Murphy miskicks. shirt grabbing by Emil Heskett.
Well, Patrick Vieira is bossing it pretty much at the moment, Martin. Good possession from Arsenal early on. I think that reflects in the way the game has gone.
And I'd be willing to bet, Andy, a good percentage of that 48% has been Liverpool in their own half. But here's Gilles Grimondi for Arsenal and Wiltor. Short numbers in the centre are Arsenal. They've got Henry.
But they normally keep a good line, but they didn't then. Also was 5-6 yards deeper than his other three defenders. But that's the man who's had to make the biggest decision of the game so far.
Kevin Pike.
And he didn't make it. Henry picks his spot. He plays it there. Now I have to say, Martin, that's a penalty. No matter what way you look at it, what angle you see it from, the arm stops a goal being scored.
And the penalty would then have equaled the red card for Anshu. But Arsenal have a terrible record with penalties. Anyway, we'll never know. It wasn't given. It should have been. Bubble. Arsenal won't want a penalty shootout today. They went out of three cups, or lost out on three cups last season on penalties.
They haven't lost an FA Cup tie for 4 years in 90 minutes, have they?
No. Yeah. 23 games. Henry. Jungberg almost got there. Arsho was able to get a foot round it, and it's Arsenal's corner this time.
Well, you always say you must try and score when you're dominating the game, when you're on top, and they're certainly on top. This is the narrowness they play with. Jungberg tucking in, but he does give them a threat through the middle, Martin, when he comes in from the right like that. Liverpool have to see this spell out.
Perez with the corner. Astabel couldn't make it his, partially because he had a problem with one of his teammates, who was Emil Heskey. Grimondi.
Oh, I needed to shout, Grimondi. I can't believe Perez here. It was wide on the left as the ball's coming across. Wasn't screaming at Grimondi. Look at Perez, bottom of the screen, absolutely spare. He doesn't move, he doesn't help his mate. Could have let him know he was there. Grimondi could have just let the ball run on. And in a great position.
Sander Westerveld, amongst the foreign players involved in this cup final, who grew up as a boyhood fan of the final via television, worldwide event, of course. Jungberg. Held up by Schmitzer. Drop for him.
Floppy ball from Lee Dixon.
Back control by Harman. Nick back for Arsenal by Pires, and Henry's on his way. He's passed Anshu. He's got Wiltor with him. No one up there on the right-hand side.
It's quite incredible, isn't it? The amount of times one of these two sides breaks, and Liverpool have the same problem. Because of the pace of the front men, they often leave everybody else behind.
It's a reclaim by Jungberg. Opia was the culpable player for Liverpool. He raises his arm in apology, the skipper today. Babel. Gerrard inviting Harman to play that to the Liverpool left with a touch off. Harman again. Wonder whether he'll get within range of David Seaman's goal, Didi Harman, and a quick free kick from just outside the penalty area.
Tried it, wasn't he? He's already tried it, man. They had the free kick in this inside right position, and he tried a very quick one, hit the wall with it.
It's Gerrard, only dropped over Heskey by a small margin. Seaman beaten twice by Harman. That's Germany v England, of course, at Wembley. Also for Newcastle v Arsenal in the Premiership. Keogh, Dixon. Vieira. Bit long by Martin Keown in the air. And Westerveld is expected to deal with that, certainly by Stefan Olsho.
You're never sure how high it's going to bounce, that's the thing. I mean, as you talk about new pitch, you're not so sure if it's going to sit up. It's just going to be a soft bounce.
It's a fine ball by Murphy. Heskey. He's got such power in his shooting, and Arsenal well aware of that. And Martin Keown's got the ball travelling more than a metre.
Brilliant closing down, not just from Keown, but Adams and Dixon got themselves around him as well. The threat was there, they realised it.
Ulrich. The threat is here for Arsenal.
There's so many men back, but if you look at that, Aiton camped on the edge of the box.
Pires. Vieira. It's often said about Arsenal, isn't it? They score so many great goals, yeah. They don't get too many bread and butter ones.
No, they don't. And a lot of people who see Arsenal week in, week out have said that that is one of the faults of the side. Fantastic to watch at the very best Arsene Wenger's side. But maybe somebody going down the line and smashing one across goal, they don't quite get enough of those.
Talking there to the kit man, Vic Akers. Maybe Fowler. Obviously bursting to be involved, the man who collected the Worthington Cup here in February. Only one club who ever done that domestic cup double, of course, and that is Arsenal in 93. Strangely, in both finals against Sheffield Wednesday.
Might have let it go, the referee. The offside flag went up. A little problem for Danny Murphy at the edge of the Arsenal box. Picked himself up, rather delicate looking at the moment. I'm sure he'll be okay.
That has been his best season as a Liverpool player. And a good day today, we'll top it off. Bump. Gerrard. Do that with Vieira around, even with Steven Gerrard's ability and the tenacity. Didn't win the ball back for Liverpool on that occasion. Oh, he got away.
Like a body's Martin. Look at the penalty area.
And Dixon is coming from a long way back. Here's Grimondi, and there's a dip on it, and there's a save for Vesterbel to have to make from Gilles Grimondi. Bub asked for want an offside, and they get one against Heskey. Cam switches now for Sky Digital viewers, channel 404, to Freddie Ljungberg, who's in a great run of form, four goals in his last five starts for Arsenal, but he's never scored in the FA Cup.
Unlucky Gerrard there, Mark. But he might have got away from Freddie Ljungberg a touch. His control just let him down, you see. Maybe he was a bit late.
See Steven Gerrard playing so many matches now. There's no talk of those groin problems, the growing pains. He's there, game in, game out.
Well, this is a little cameo how this game's been played. Arsenal possession, Liverpool very, very deep. Defending in numbers with discipline. Hoping to break.
Pires. Ljungberg chugging into space. And of course the gamble is how many Arsenal players will they push on. Liverpool would love to suck them forward, and they've got the artillery to hit the Gunners on the break.
I'd like to see Liverpool be a touch more adventurous, I have to say, Mark. You wonder, I mean, Gerrard really has been cautious at certain games this year before he come here and have a go. But maybe it's a credit to Arsenal, the way they've controlled the ball.
Vieira. Pires. Ooh, there was a tangle there on the edge of the area. Was Ljungberg trying to make more of that than he should have done? Did Carragher really foul him?
Well, it goes on time and time again. It really is a tough one for the officials to call. It wasn't coming together as Ljungberg tried to make the run.
Babel wants to play it back by Pires. Keown got into the back of the Liverpool striker.
This is where they're narrow. Really on the seat, no real width. Only full backs were there to provide any width.
Ulrich. across the pitch than towards his intended target. It was a poor ball, and he was so annoyed that he started to chase it himself. He realised that maybe it's just worth keeping the energy. Of course, the capacity for change later on in the game influenced the match is of a high order for both these clubs. Carragher. It's a corner, and despite Lee Dixon picking it up and hurling it back, he's done it already, pointed.
Just inquiring about the push, Lee Dixon there, Mark. He felt he was nudged.
This is his 50th FA Cup appearance for Arsenal, Dixon. His job at the moment within it is to guard the post.
They need to be disciplined here, Arsenal, because they've dominated the game. They wouldn't like to be sloppy in the marking and give a goal away from a set play.
Simmons missed it. Oh, well, sympathy from the referee, given a free kick in Arsenal's favour. Perez was vigilant behind him.
Well, he comes into a few bodies here. I'm not so sure who he runs into, Martin. But I think that's a generous decision for the England goalkeeper. Really generous.
Keeping jersey for Arsenal. There's a FA Cup story about that, when they lost the FA Cup back in the 20s to Cardiff, when the cup came to the city that's hosting the final today through a goalkeeping error supposedly caused by the sheen on a new jersey. Been part of Arsenal folklore since then.
I've heard there's some excuses. That's a belter.
Didn't help that the Arsenal goalkeeper was a Welsh international as well. 1927 it was.
How did you like that? And my jersey was too shiny, yeah.
Owen and Adams,
good tackle.
If they lost the Cup, Arsenal to Cardiff, then they've got a chance of taking it to Highbury from Cardiff today. They played well enough in the opening 35 minutes to suggest that it's well within their reach, but of course, when they come to study the replays, they'll be supporting Thierry Henry's claim that they should have had a penalty. Herpia. Able to have a look around to see where Michael Owen is.
That should be food and drink for Adams and Kieran, shouldn't it, Martin? And that's been what Liverpool have only been able to do, is just knock it from back to front, not really giving Owen and Esco much of a chance at all.
Well, that's the FA Umbro Trophy final tomorrow at noon. Canby Island and Forest Green have done brilliantly to get to that occasion. It's at Villa Park. And Birmingham against Preston tomorrow at 2:30. Sky Sports 1, Sky Sports Extra. And of course, it's from the playoffs, semi-final first leg. Perez has started all of Arsenal's FA Cup games. Scored goals against Queen's Park Rangers, against Blackburn Rovers. And winning against Spurs in the semi-final. That's the first time he's played against Liverpool. From the start, Alex. Here is Keogh. Henry drifting to the left. That ball off it. Dudley for his own benefit. Saw Henry off in doing so. Adams with the head, then Vieira, shot for an offside, I think it was a good one against Wiltor, but the flag stayed down and Arsenal have it with Dixon. This is Gilles Grimondi. Cole. Henri. 3-4-5 forward for Arsenal here. The first line of defence. Pires. Wiltor. Didn't give Ljungberg any sort of chance, really. Perez has kept in play Vieira's header. Jungberg. And the better of Harmat, supported by Grimondi. Trying to win a corner there, or just floated in towards the near post. Didn't come off for Grimondi, who was a substitute but didn't get on when Arsenal were last in the final in 98, their double year.
It takes two teams to make a final, a classic, Martin. Gerard Houllier's team haven't really played up till now for me.
Adams. The referee not helping Schmitzer. Towards him, Arsenal got in and around him, and they're back on the ball again with Pires.
Great touch from Vieira, Mark. They got back in, a little toe poke was all it took.
Jungberg working with Wiltor. Still Sylvain Wiltor for Arsenal. Will get the better of Carragher, who's fought tooth and nail. And it's a goal kick.
It's a good little contest, isn't it?
It's not much of what we've seen so far.
Yeah, I thought if he checks anymore, I'm going to get dizzy, Sylvain Wiltor. You can see it's a good decision. Did come off from last.
Arsenal probing, Liverpool defending. Amazing Liverpool, 116 goals they've scored this season. But at times they do know how to make it a war of attrition.
Well, they can defend, they've shown that this season, Mark, in big games. You know, but they don't have a responsibility to entertain here, the footballers. They have a responsibility to win this cup competition for themselves and the fans. I mean, that's the last 10 minutes of the football match, and those stats reflect exactly what we're seeing. But Arsenal haven't scored. Well dominated, well in control. And there's no doubt Liverpool only have to put one move together, Martin. Only have to prize Arsenal open once. And then Heskey and Owen, they do have strikers who can finish it off.
Michael Owen is further forward than Heskey, who got the ball to feet. And to be fair to Gerard Houllier, he has played the two up front. At the times away in Europe, one of them has been wide. Heskey was in Barcelona. And the end that justified the means. Osho. It's a good block by Pires. Henri. 4 minutes plus added time to go to half-time. It's got to be something of a stop-start affair, the high temperatures in South Wales. Big factor today.
I think the pitch is well. It is slow. Ball doesn't travel along the grass at good speed. So that in itself slows the game down.
Jungberg. The one pass that travelled on the right speed for Arsenal to really create a chance that will, unless something gives in these last 3 minutes or so, be the main thrust of the half-time chat. George Graham, Graham Souness, Harry Redknapp.
It'll be interesting to see how they feel about Liverpool's performance, Mark. Or lack of.
And he's offside. Well, an early goal for either side might have changed it, but I think it's settled in to the sort of pattern that many experts were anticipating. Keogh.
That's what I said to you, it was my worry at the top of the show, that we have all the ingredients here. with a special kick, but it hasn't quite worked out that way. But Arsene Wenger, I think, and we'll look back and think, well, my team have played well. The only thing that has been missed has been the goal, and but for the intervention of the left arm of Stefan Onsho, his team would have that goal. But Gerard Houllier is the one, as we approach half-time, with the problems, with the decisions to make.
Wiltord, Ljungberg, Chris Babbel just helped it on its way.
It must be so frustrating when you put in a ball that kind of quality, and there's only really one target.
Cole, Pires. This is no one really bursting to make up the ground to get in there from Arsenal's midfield, and they don't get too many goals like that. Dixon. Lindbergh's had a good first half. Grimondi. Now Keogh. Arsenal's free kick. Instantly taken by Vieira. Wiltord trying to get Cole down the back of Babbel. Because Babbel playing in a domestic cup final for the fourth successive season. And last three, of course, the German cup final with Bayern Munich. 1-2, lost one.
Well, when you talk about Babbel and Carragher in particular, how often have you seen those at the edge of the other box, Martin?
We haven't. And closing down and challenging, leaving Owen and Heskey often to their own devices. Of course, they can be match-winning devices. Mm. David Seaman is the boss there.
Minute, Martin, we have here. Very difficult to see it in this one, but I promise you it's 1 minute of added time.
Into that. Babbel.
Just not happening for him at the moment. More promise, that's the kind of things that I think Marcus Babbel has to be doing. But I do think they conceded ground too early, Liverpool. I do think that they should maybe start defending a little bit higher up the pitch. By that I mean the front men, instead of dropping off to the halfway line conceding ground, if they might just try pushing a little bit higher up the pitch.
It's goalless at the end of the first half. The 2001 FA Cup final, it might not have been if the flag had been raised by Kevin Pike when Stefan Onsho handled a goal-bound shot from Thierry Henry, who was put clear by a delightful ball from Freddie Ljungberg. Arsenal have tried to force the play. Liverpool looking to soak it up and strike on the break. At half-time at the Millennium Stadium, it's 0-0.
Keeper is an option, Tom.
Yeah, I think it is. They're alternating Wiltord and Henry at the moment, but it's not working at all, is it? You know, Wiltord's not really in it. I think he will be replaced. By whom? Well, we'll need to wait and see.
Mm. Nick?
I think Henry's a good chance. He's certainly got the pace, Tommy, as Andy Gray says. So I think the further...
You've got to have pace.
The further Wenger pushes him upfield, the better.
Yes.
But why is he playing so wide? Because something's happening in the Liverpool tactics, in the Liverpool defence,
which is forcing
Thierry Henry very wide, wider than we've seen
the two central defenders. The two central defenders are obviously doing a splendid job, and he subsequently has to be pulled wide in order to pick the ball up and run at the defenders.
Well, then perhaps Bergkamp is the option.
I think this is a tactic of Liverpool's. They're very, very clever, and they make Arsenal cross these balls in, and the two big fellas in the middle are winning the ball in the air.
All right, just before we go back, finally, Tom, what about Heskey and Owen? Would you make a change there?
I think Fowler will get a run later on. These two are getting no room whatsoever from Adams and Keogh, who I said earlier, I think they're having excellent, excellent games.
All right, second half of the Cup Final about to kick off. Let's go back to Martin Tyler and Andy Gray.
Steve Dunn just checking. Got the watches are ready, but the players are of the right number on each side. And in fact, they are the same 22 that started the game. Pesky. Gerrard. Babel get the chance to push forward as Lee Dixon tried to do in that sway of sunlight on the far side.
Well, I certainly think it was decision time in there. The Liverpool dressing room at half-time, Martin, they must have seriously thought of making changes with personnel. They haven't got hold of the football. I wondered if he'd toyed with the option of bringing on McAllister. Lovely passer of the ball, can control it, can influence it. I think the two wide players in Murphy and Schmeichel have been disappointing. That would have been the two areas that he must have looked at.
There's Patrick Berger to be called upon, perhaps. Jamie Redknapp you saw in the background then. Of course, it's been a season of recovery for him, and the recovery not quite quick enough to participate here. Pires. Now Cole, stopped by Bub. And we're going to settle into the same sort of pattern again. With Arsenal moving forward, Liverpool defending, trying to hit quickly through the power of Heskey in particular, the lightning running of Owen.
On the patient side, Arsenal man, much has been talked about Liverpool being patient and sitting in and bedding in and waiting for it to happen. And so can Arsenal, even though they dominate. I think in the semi-final against Tottenham was a wonderful example of controlled, patient football. They just knew they were going to win it, I felt.
Pat Rice might be wondering whether this will be a repeat of 30 years ago, and it was 0-0 and sorted out in extra time. He was on the winning side then, even though Liverpool scored first in the extra period through Steve Highway. Jackson purpose, and Michael Owen is now available for you if you're watching on Sky Digital. If you want a close analysis of his movements for the next few minutes, he's under the gaze of the player cam, and his bustling work there has earned Liverpool a free kick. And they do have Sammy Herpia, a giant defender, who's hanging in.
It's beaten away by Simon. Just a reaction from the Arsenal goalkeeper, but it was enough. Herpia was trying to get in and follow it up. He's been forced wide here, and in the end, Arsenal get a free kick. They could easily have been a goal down.
Well, that's what I mean. If it only takes a second, this isn't good marking. Heskey's muscles his way in there. He really does use his pace and his strength. And if this is either side of David Seaman, then that's the first goal. Good reactions from the goalkeeper. So close from Heskey. But that proves you can dominate and dominate, Mark. If you don't turn that domination into goals, that's all it takes.
Gerrard. And the referee, well, whether we didn't hear it, he didn't seem to blow straight away, but it is a free kick in favour of Patrick Vieira and Arsenal. Vieira again. Pires. Cleared by Harman. Not much more than that. Although Heskey's trying to make something of it. Met by Adams. Penultimate season, he says. At Arsenal for Mr. Arsenal. Adams there again. What we have got in the second half is Liverpool attacking the Liverpool end and Arsenal attacking the Arsenal end. The acoustics, one would expect to be even more impressive. Vieira. and Gerrard, two true Scousers. Looking for the win that would light up the red side of Liverpool today. Murphy.
He got himself in some lovely space, Danny Murphy, there, Martin. Always fed into him. Turned on it. Not a great pass, I have to say, for him.
Vieira. Now Cole. Shaking up with Wiltor. Liverpool might feel that was an unnecessary free kick to give away. Didi Harman, who got into trouble against Arsenal at Highbury and was actually dismissed, although one of the yellow cards was revoked later on, and he didn't get the full punishment for his problems in that game. Towards Wiltor, who's hit six FA Cup goals, remember, and had a sight of number seven in the final itself.
Nice strike, struck it well enough, clean, pure. It's a crowd seeing Tony Adams gathering his team. We've got the red arrows from that area.
Corner and into Vieira's area, and of course slipped at the crucial moment. That's a quick restart by Vestergaard, trying to get Liverpool onto the front foot. They have to backpedal again because Pires has fed Thierry Henry.
A free kick, has to be. He's troubled on show mark. Anytime he's got 1v1, he's skint him. He's clumsy. He's lucky it's a couple of yards the other side of that line.
Liverpool have to defend delivery from the Arsenal left again. Not a corner this time, but further in from the free kick. Again, it's Pires. Vestergaard could have caught that. To him.
Yeah, he might have just felt he was a little bit at full stretch. And I think if he feels that, then rather than attempt to catch it and drop it in front of him, he just decided to flick it away.
It was no more than a flick, though, was it? Not a real punch, but
no.
Liverpool first to it. Now they've got a throw with Carragher. Gerrard. We'll get there, but Babel won the challenge. Well, the long legs of Vieira dispossessed him. Wiltor. Arsenal need to get some support up with it. Ljungberg is there. Pires. Well, it's run rather kindly for Robert Pires. Great tackle by Carragher. Stayed on his feet, didn't lose the sense of balance, was able to just check and change his direction. Liverpool badly needed him to do that.
Defending was a little bit more desperate there, though.
Adams and Keown are up for Arsenal again. Met by Herpia. Such a tower of strength defensively for Liverpool. Back by Pires. Athletic turn from him. Lee Dixon surveys the scene. That's on by Grimondi, and well, there was a chance there, but Arsenal were a bit flat-footed around the Frenchman.
Oh, he was in particular. Took Grimondi a bit of stick for the flick there. I think there was an awful lot wrong with it. There wasn't an awful lot more he could do with it. The action areas will make an interesting viewing. One of the same.
I took the very words. Here is Herpia. Pattern re-established in the second half. Ljungberg. But no breakthrough for Arsenal. given against Ljungberg.
I can understand his frustration. That's much ado about nothing, that. Just the linesman getting busy, I think.
Freddie Ljungberg is, if you like, the odd run out. Not the haircut I'm referring to. But he's neither English nor French. He's a Swede. Stadium reverberating for the support for Arsenal and Liverpool here. Signs that the momentum that was maybe lacking in the first half is starting to get into the match. It's Arsenal again trying to inject it. And, Liverpool very solid in their defensive play.
Schmeichel. That is absolutely football of the highest quality.
Patrick Vieira on the prowl, but Henry takes it from him. Now Vieira, now Ljungberg. Wiltor and Henry are in the centre. Cole going to the left of Pirès. Henry. Oh, no, juggled past two, but not past the third, but now he's in! It's Thierry!
Absolutely fantastic play from Thierry Henry. He just misses the ball. That's the only thing he does wrong. We are trying to poke it past Sander Vesterdal, but Ashley Cole coming in, goalkeeping. He can only stab at the ball. What a clearance!
Sammy, hope you're on the line.
Gracious me.
Well, the major goal mouth incidents in this game, and there haven't been too many of them, have been in the Liverpool penalty area. Cole.
Well, Arsenal have come to play, today, and Liverpool have come to defend.
Henry. It's much more desperate, the defending now by Liverpool.
Really surprised, the card's out already, yeah. It's desperate. Arsenal sent it. They smell it. Crowd seen again, and it's a lunge, really.
Hello for Bama.
I just think Gerard Houllier has to make a change. So, I mean, I think he should have thought about that at half-time, I really do.
Well, the horse hasn't bolted yet.
Not yet.
It's a long way out for Ori, and it's a long way wide.
Well, Cole's chance. He's young. He's inexperienced. I just wondered, could he have taken a touch in it? Could he have controlled it and smashed it in? Well, that's the flick, but he's unlucky. He just missed the ball. But you see it arrive at him, and he just prods at it. And I just wonder if it was the opportunity for him just to take the sting out the ball, control it, take the touch, but obviously he felt he had to deal with it immediately. And the big man, he's a big target. How important might that clearance prove to be?
Pirès was blocked off there, but scientifically, if that's not a contradiction in terms, and the referee wasn't aware of it. Vieira. Ljungberg. Carragher. Heskey's hardly had a touch in the second half, certainly not in this part of the pitch except for that header. And now he's played it. Selfishly,
that's
to go in by surprise.
That's it. Wasn't it worth going the right leg at that?
And he's got the power and the right boot that he has. Grimaldi. Arsenal feel they're the bosses here, but it doesn't show on the scoreline. And FA Cup final history will tell you that having a lot of the ball is not always a guarantee of going home in the right frame of mind.
Change has been made, Martin.
Gary McAllister, 20th season of his senior career, but certainly not in his twilight yet. He's been in brilliant form, and it's only really the need of a switch in midfield that cost him his place in the starting lineup, and they've now sacrificed Gerard Houllier, one of the midfield defenders. Harman has just been booked, maybe that's come into it. On comes a player with the capability to create, and my goodness, Liverpool need that at the moment.
They need the ball, they need a player who can control the ball. We might well find that the swap actually Gerard and McAllister Martin. Gerard plays the Harman role just in front of the back four. McAllister's allowed to go and try and influence the game at the other end.
Oh, there's some honourable play by Michael Owen then, because I think if he'd gone to ground, he might have got himself a free kick. Just chase the ball. Arsenal on the ball. Four forward.
Offside.
Too far forward.
Oh dear, what a chance. Yet again, what about Vieira at the halfway line? Wins the ball and they spring forward brilliantly, but there's no need to be offside. Perez is looking right along the line. He must just hold his line.
Strategy, Andy, to draw Arsenal's sting for an hour and
no.
Send on McAllister.
I don't think you can set a team out and say draw the sting for an hour. You might be 3-0 down, Mark. Mm. And they certainly could be 2 down.
Perpia. Pavel with only Michael Owen to try and find him. He's found it. Good hold up play by Owen. McAllister slipped, but Gerrard was there behind him. To our left, we'd like to see a more close-up view of the action, of which in the second half has been at the opposite end of the ground. Vieira, Wiltor won't get it, Vestergaard will.
Great goalkeeping.
And a massive clearance for Heskey to chase. Down goes Ashley Cole.
That's debatable, isn't it?
Vieira allowed to turn. Wiltor, goalkeeper's come again, helped out by the perimeters of the pitch, if you like.
Well, that was a good start position. Boots having a problem with them. About to be changed. But he's positioning for the through ball from Vieira, not the last one, the one just before it, Martin. It was excellent.
Digital viewers watching with the interactive facilities. Sander Vesterveld getting some help with his footwear from Peggy Arfexad, the backup goalkeeper, who was the goalkeeper who helped knock Arsenal out of the FA Cup last season when he was with Leicester City. Penalty shootout. Teammates, he did have a lot of time.
And he had a look, and once he looked away from the ball, Mark, he kind of lost the flight of it.
Dropped the catch, so to speak.
Yeah.
Gerrard. Picking out Marcus Babbel. Carlson trying to get there.
Well, I think the change has helped him, there's no doubt. I think Gerrard looks to be comfortable in there now, just sitting. And he can get the ball and he can pass it. And I'm no doubt Gary McAllister will be happy being asked to do the job he's been asked to. That's get the ball, try and influence the game high up the pitch.
Ori. He wants to try and place it. Ljungberg arriving. Freddie Ljungberg, it's off the line again. Arsenal once more come very close to scoring the first goal here in Cardiff.
I don't think you can keep missing chances like this in a cup final, especially as good chances.
Well, we wonder whether it would come for them in the semi-final.
Yeah.
There's plenty then.
They keep going, don't they? Yeah. And I didn't think Tottenham had the cutting edge that Liverpool had. And that might be the difference, Martin.
Oh, really? Oh, he's not there. Nicely Cole. That's Freddie Ljungberg went to try and chip it.
Well, the first chance is... Henry's, man, I thought he'd really go at the defender and commit him, he didn't. But this is just stood up, he tries to nick it in the top corner. It's quite a simple header in the end with the goalkeeper in his face.
And Pat Rice, Arsene Wenger and company
frustration.
Are frustrated. Sami Hupia twice off the line in the second half. Will try to pile forward again. Oh, Dixon's been stranded. Carragher. Schmitz's behind Grimondi. Adams has to come across. Schmitz's on his own. He's looking for help. It's not there yet. Now Owen. McAllister square of him. McAllister's in the middle. And Steven Gerrard started to come forward. He's checked back now. Liverpool keep it and work it and switch it back to Owen. Touch by Cole. Get beyond Ljungberg and it's hoisted in by Murphy. Just over 20 minutes of regulation time left. Arsenal 0, Liverpool 0. A more open second half. Most of it caused by Arsenal's thrust, but Liverpool, particularly since the arrival of Gary McAllister, reminding us all that they have strong attacking options of their own. Heskey's had a header saved by a rather startled Seaman. And Heskey's in there again. And again. Gerrard, who loved to shoot from long range, didn't hit it well, it was a shot. it might have turned out to be the perfect pass.
Well, anyone alive and going in it. It's taken it in on goal, but it is a much better second half. It's been more open. That's reflected. The attempts we're having now. And only the Heskey header. And only one to test the England goalkeeper.
Well, it's four Arsenal on target. Two off the line and a handball.
Not enough for a cup win though, mate.
And no nearer knowing who's going to collect the first FA Cup to be presented in Cardiff. Gerrard. Heskey and Keogh. And they haven't possibly round on the cover.
Old trust, isn't it?
Mm.
Yes. He trusted his mate was going to win the header.
Well, he did that. He gave Heskey a bit of a headache in passing as well.
Arsenal about to make a change, Martin. Straight Parlour. I think Grimaldi will be the one to come off. I think that would be the most natural change for me. And I notice Cano has been signalled to come trotting back. So it may be a double substitution. Or certainly two in quick succession.
Westerveld scuffed his clearance. Pires.
Oh, it's Ljungberg round the goalkeeper. Freddie Ljungberg for Arsenal.
They've knocked and knocked and knocked, and finally the door. Look at Ljungberg's run, in behind, perfect timing, perfect touch, perfect finish. We have our first goal.
Well, he's been in goal-getting form so impressively in recent games. This is five now in his last six starts. That's what earned him his place in the starting 11. And Arsene Wenger says, yes, at last.
Change on hold, I think he turned around and said, Martin, let's just see. I might need Grimaldi's defensive ability now in midfield.
Well, it's game on now because soaking up and really trying to play just as the counter-attackers might not be enough. Liverpool needs something extra. The Swede has struck for Arsenal. Stops it dropping for Owen. Ljungberg. Monchot has to turn, and given the handball in the first half, you feel that at the moment justice is being done.
The better team are winning. There's absolutely not a shadow of a doubt. The team that's come to play and win against Gerard Houllier's team, who's, well, I don't say he came to defend, Martin, but they've been forced to defend for the best part of 75 minutes.
Tidied up by Adams. Ljungberg's pass. Henry, Thierry Henry. Westerveld has saved it. Henry's there again. And once more, Perpier off the line. Arsenal really could have put it to bed then.
Oh, and he should have put it to bed. Never mind, could have put it to bed. Thierry Henry should have scored.
McAllister. Owen. It's still 1-0 to the Arsenal. Murphy. Murphy, and he went flattering in to Keown, who had eyes only for the ball.
Well, he's got his hands in his head, Martin. He's had a glorious opportunity here. He's absolutely tormented Stephen Osho, and he does so again here on the edge of the box. It might well have been a penalty again there, a hand striking the ball. It's a magnificent save from Vesterville. You have to say, this save is absolutely brilliant. But as it dropped, he really should have done better. It might have made it over the line, but Sammy Hoopier's hat-trick saves the day.
And he knows unusual FA Cup final hat-trick. Vesterveld has been protected by three goal-line clearances from the tall Finnish defender. Silva Wiltord is coming off. Ray Parler is on.
Well, that's a change, because I guarantee you it was Grimaldi that was coming on, Martin, prior to that goal. Because we're searching for a goal, that would have been a natural thing. But now they need the protection. Ljungberg, I feel sure, will be given the role just off of Thierry Henry. Parler will come right side, and that'll be it. And you just feel sure that Gerard Houllier has got to respond now with Robbie Fowler.
Well, Robbie Fowler, whose record against Arsenal is played 13, 11 goals, a couple of hat-tricks. One would do at the moment for Gerard Houllier, one goal to extend the game. And Patrick Berger as well. Danny Murphy departs.
It won't be one of the front men, I feel sad about that. Might be Murphy and Schmitza. I'm not sure who the other one will be.
He's getting the numbers right. That's obviously more difficult than it seems. Put the push-button technology.
Well, I can't see it, you see. I think it's Schmitza. It wouldn't make any sense to be any other player, Martin.
He goes off for his Czech mate, who's going to come on the left-hand side, Patrick Berger. And it's Fowler up with Owen. Heskey's moving slightly right side. But really, a chance for a three-pronged attack for Liverpool. They're a goal down to Freddie Ljungberg and Arsenal. Two-pronged attack at the moment.
Well, he's keeping the two there, Mark. Yes, he's going to play Heskey, it seems, from the right-hand side. Played against Spain when he came on second half for England in that position. Quite familiar to him. There's not a problem with it.
Well, almost identical to the time that Chelsea scored against Aston Villa in the last final at the old Wembley a year ago. 72nd minute for Freddie Ljungberg here.
Well, I don't expect Arsenal to be rushing now, Martin, to take set pieces, corners, throw-ins, and use as much time as they can. It looks like it's less than 12 minutes on that clock on the top left, but I think we'll find there might be two or three extra minutes of added time.
Crisply and significantly well forward. Paul Thompson, an FA Cup winner in his Liverpool playing days, of course, 1974. Keogh. Stabbed forward by Grimaldi. Hoopier.
I think for us at the English side, Mark, it's very important for them to keep playing. I don't think you should invite Liverpool back into the game.
You have to go back to 1993, Andy, to find an FA Cup final in which both teams scored. And that was involving Arsenal, one of those teams, the other was Sheffield Wednesday. And they both just scored in the replay as well, until Andy Linegan settled it with the decisive goal in the dying seconds of extra time of a second bite of it. Vieira.
That's sloppy. So, I mean, you cannot afford to do that. So, I mean, about inviting the team back in. That just gives Liverpool a little lift. someone doesn't, even something as daft as that. And Arsenal are trying to do to Liverpool what Liverpool did to Arsenal for the best part of 70 minutes.
Gerrard. It's Owen. Keown. Well, that was a classic confrontation. The sharp striker at the top of his game and the old hand, but still quick. Martin Keown, good enough to be an England captain during the course of this season.
What a tackle. I have to say, I don't know whether the pitch didn't help Michael Owen. I thought it would have been slow. He didn't quite get it out of his feet quick enough or far enough.
Offside. Well, he's disappointed.
But it was moments earlier than a through ball. And that's just a ball through the middle. And they get caught, the two centre-backs, but look at Keown. See, plays it across his body, Michael Owen, and maybe in front of him would have been the place. Because going across his body gave Keown the chance to get back in.
All right. Ljungberg. That was outside him.
No.
Wanted a bit more glory.
Lee Parler won't be happy. Just give him the ball. Got good support coming in as well. You've got Perez coming from the other side. You see him making the ground. You've got Henri trotting in. Keep the ball.
And you just scored your first FA Cup goal. I suppose you want more.
I was just quite happy with the one myself.
Well, you've got more than one. You just got one in an FA Cup final. That's his first ever in the competition. Will it be decisive? Still time for Liverpool to give a different dimension to the day. Carragher taking on Parler, who just impeded him.
Well, they're trying to get the line in the box. Tony Adams saying penalty spot. We don't drop deeper. Give the goalkeeper a chance. But I guarantee you they will drop. It's a natural thing to do. I'm going to drop. Probably end up 6 yard box. Look how deep they're going. Pressure's in there.
Keown got to it. Adams trying to be strong. So was Babel. 1-1. Michael Owen. It was from the set piece. Arsenal couldn't clear. And Owen has struck.
What a finish. Scrappy, scrappy goal. Look how deep the drop. They don't deal with it. I'm really surprised. And I have to say at the back post, Martin, Babel out muscles Tony Adams. Really surprised here. Adams goes to it, so does Babel. Babel keeps the ball alive. And well, the hottest of hot Liverpool strikers at the moment. Just turns, swings, hits, and it's a wonderful reply.
Well, we haven't seen too many Julio smiles today, but suddenly now it's Liverpool who are having a say on Cardiff's big day, and it's Berger, and it hits Keown, and Liverpool have the corner.
Well, that's a free kick to me. Tony Adams went to play the ball. That was a blatant push there. They got away with it. But it's the one place where they've looked to trouble Arsenal today, strangely, is from set plays.
Well, Liverpool, known these days, is a physically powerful side. It showed as the challenges were won for the ball to drop for Owen. And the big men are in there in the gold shirts again. Berger. McAllister is onside. In early, but too early maybe for his teammates. Certainly too long for his teammates.
Arsenal's change again. This is going to be an interesting one. Cooper Ljungberg, a feel, the goal scorer.
Well, it wasn't the winner for Freddie Ljungberg. Kanu, incredibly, comes into this season's FA Cup for the first time. In a way, of course, at times with the Nigeria, he's had one or two little injuries as well. He's been out of favour at times. But he's playing in the final.
When you watch this game back, Matt, you'll find it hard to believe that the result of this game is still in doubt. Really, that engraver should have written Arsenal on that trophy already.
That's a good job he didn't.
And as we stand now, you just couldn't call it.
Here's Connor.
And McAllister.
Here's the tide turning against Arsenal. Fowler. Owen with it. Robbie Fowler almost using Owen as a decoy and picking a route through. Ball to Thierry Henry. Arm busting run this late in the game. And Arsenal couldn't get the support up there. Cole.
I can't believe he thought someone kept up with
Carragher. So both sides have scored in the FA Cup final. Fowler. Suddenly Arsenal look crippled.
Released here as a young footballer who has a point to prove to his manager, and that's Robbie Fowler. You could see quite clearly how upset he was at being left out when they arrived at this football ground this afternoon, Martin. Almost close to tears I felt watching the young man come in. He's been given the opportunity to say, hey, I should have been playing, I'm going to make a point here. And already he's come very close to breaking through and breaking past managing Keown.
Since Fowler came on, but capable of doing the job in the wide position. McAllister, Berger, too heavy with a touch.
I think Arsenal are shell-shocked. I really mean that. I think they believed that they were going on to win this game. They've dominated it for 80 minutes.
But in many ways, it's been a cameo of their season, yeah. Andy, because they have not scored many away goals. That's not to say they haven't made many away chances, because they have. They've lacked maybe the ruthless touch outside of Highbury. They haven't shown it today, particularly after scoring, when other opportunities manifested themselves. And it's far from game over at the Millennium Stadium. Berger. Oh, and Owen will brush past Dixon. Cross comes at him. Owen! Absolutely magnificent. Michael Owen has turned the FA Cup final on its head.
So long, outplayed. Arsenal only have themselves to blame.
squandered chance after chance after chance that could have wrapped up this game. I think it's too little too late possibly for Dennis Bergkamp as we approach the time that will be added on.
We're into that.
Momentum going on. where Michael is a special player.
How difficult was it for you to pick yourself up emotionally after being left out? You must have been gutted.
Look, it's happened to a few players this season. You know, the manager looks to see how you respond. You know, you've got to take it, but I was disappointed, but the end result doesn't matter, does it?
A special mention for the captain here, Sammy Hoopier. Three clearances off the line.
Thank you. I happened to be in the right place at the right time, and I was a little bit lucky with those, but 2-1.
The longer the game went on with Arsenal not taking their chances, did you think we can hold on? But when they finally scored, it must have been difficult to keep your resolve going.
Yeah, it was difficult, and we had to take our chances and take some risk, and it paid off, and I'm very happy.
What did the manager say at half-time? Because you were so deep in the air under so much pressure.
No, he just said that do your job, and it comes good.
Well done. Go and enjoy the celebration.
The great goal scorers who get the goals on the great day, but it was today.
It was. It was set for the young lad, Martin. Much has been made, headlines he has made himself from a very young age. And this must be beyond his wildest dreams, I have to say. He sat through the World League Cup final, he didn't get a sniff, he didn't get his boots on the grass. For a long time, he was as ineffective, Martin, in this game as he was in the World League Cup. He do, but my God, when he was asked a question, when he's asked could he finish in a high pressure situation, when it really matter, with the eyes of the world on him, he answered those questions emphatically. We must be nearly there. It's a longer game than Arsenal. Takes a touch longer to do, but it's that young man, his finishing ability, that means it's Liverpool who are the 2001 FA Cup winners.
Well, let's hear from Gerard Houllier, who's with Claire Tomlinson. Well, Gerard, not quite ready yet, and if he's got some players to see and hug and congratulate, you can only understand that. But Michael Owen, a hat-trick against Newcastle, 2 in midweek against Chelsea, that was great enough, but, well, he's... blown us all away today. He's certainly blown Arsenal away. And Gerard Houllier is now ready.
Arsenal dominated much of the possession, much of the territory. You were playing much on the counter-attack.
They were a better side. They are a counter-attacking team as well. I mean, their best move and their best opportunity is when we lost the ball in front of their box.
Did it change when you brought on Gary McAllister?
I think he gave a more flow in the game. I was not happy with the area where everything should start from. And when he came on, he did a lot, yes.
And a word on Michael Owen. 2 goals for him.
How can you describe that? He's been like that for a month. And today he made the difference again. But I think the sub today, the player that came on, brought some energy and some stamina as well. Because the heat is terrible. But I don't think so, but you know.
And Sammy Hoopier, 3 off the line.
Yeah, he did. But they had some chances. But every time it was, you know, because we didn't pass the ball well from behind. We're not used to that. I think we were a bit nervous. The team is just progressing. It's a young team. When we started, I don't think we were 25 of average of age. So let them give them time. But it's splendid for the fans, it's splendid for the day. I mean, I'm proud for the Liverpool people.
2 cups won, 2 more cup finals to come.
You're right. So the celebration will be reduced to nothing.
Thanks, Gerard.
Well, the name is on the cup. The name is up in lights. It's Liverpool. It's Michael Owen. As Gerard Houllier said, Arsenal did miss some chances. They paid a heavy price.
Well, for every victor, Mark, there has to be a team that loses, and I've just been, well, listening to the interviews, looking at the Arsenal players. I said that the goal, Michael's first goal, shell-shocked, and it did. They never recovered from that, really. And I just think, you know, there are players there. Thierry Henry there, lying flat out. He hasn't moved since the final whistle, Mark. He must be going through time and time again the chances he had. It was a tale of two strikers for me. Two strikers who had chances to win the match.
one in Michael Owen who took them and took them with such authority, and one in Thierry Henry who will look back on this day and think it should have been me.
It was him. And in a season where there's silverware in abundance heading for Anfield, no major trophy at Highbury for a third consecutive campaign. Well, the presentation party are making their way out. There's no 39 steps here at Cardiff. If there is one facility it's lacking, it's a natural presentation area. The podium has to be placed on the pitch. And it's now in place. Still, you feel, amidst the Liverpool delight, an air of disbelief.
Well, do you believe it? I mean, you've seen many cup finals, Mr. Tyler, this.
I mean, well, sometimes it's not the advantage to score first in a final.
Well, I understand that, but...
But usually by the 72nd minute it is.
And having been dominated as to the extent that they were?
30 years ago, 2-1 to Arsenal, Liverpool scored first. A mirror image today. Officials are getting their mementos, and the losers, as is customary, show up. Arsenal, another second place if you like. Certainly Liverpool are a hoodoo side for them. They've only beaten them once in the last 17 meetings now, and the defeats in that run, well, this will be the most painful of all. And they still have a couple more league games to come. At Newcastle on Tuesday, then at Southampton. And they still need a point to ensure another second place in the Premiership.
Well, I think it's time for reflection for Arsene Wenger, Martin Arsenal. Second consecutive year, nothing to show for it. They respect silverware. It's now the double winning season since Arsenal won anything. And I think that that man will not be happy with that. And he will have time now to reflect on what has to be done and where Arsenal go from here.
Arsenal, who once lost the FA Cup to Cardiff, have now lost it in Cardiff. Now, Liverpool have been through their captains this season. Jamie Redknapp hasn't played, but he's with the team. Robbie Fowler, of course, collected the Worthington Cup. Sammy Herpier led the team out today. The captains are queuing up for this.
Well, I know our dad in our studio may have a little tear in his eye at the moment.
Well, the Millennium Stadium has forged a strong link with Merseyside this season. Liverpool with a monopoly on the cups at Cardiff. The FA Cup now goes to Liverpool. Gerard Houllier's men in jubilation here. Greta, because it looked as though they were going to be on the wrong end of this day of extreme emotions. Of course they've rode a bit of luck today. It should have been a first half penalty, but when the firepower was needed in the final, Liverpool had it. Emil Heskey, who scored 5 goals to get them to the final. They've seen off challengers from outside the top division in Rotherham, Tranmere and Wycombe Wanderers. There's the man of the moment. Premiership scouts in Leeds, a great away win over a side who beat them twice in the Premiership.
Manchester City. And now the Gunners have gone by the wayside. And that's the story that means the FA Cup going to Anfield for a sixth time. Fairy tale time for 36-year-old Gary McAllister.
I just wonder, Mark, much has been made. You talked about goals winning games, you're absolutely right. We cast the mind back to 1-0. Henry one-on-one with only that man to beat. The left hand comes up, blocks it. I said it might be a big save. My goodness, it was a big save.
Well, the good times are coming back to Liverpool Football Club with Gerard Houllier at the helm. And Michael Owen. Andy Gray, your thoughts about the venue?
I think what we see, Martin, the stadium gives a magnificent atmosphere. The pitch played better than many people thought. I can't fault it, if you want my honest opinion. I can't fault it. And I think everyone who's been here will remember it, certainly some for different reasons. But it's been a wonderful day, it's been a wonderful occasion.
Well, wherever you play it, it's the FA Cup, it's the grand old tournament, it's produced an archetypal final, really. And the setting has been in South Wales, where they could not have been more welcoming. And Liverpool will be heading home in the highest of spirits, probably with some spirits inside them as well, and taking with them the FA Cup. They've come west and they've won.
The young and the old here, McAllister and Owen.
Well, let's get some more comments from those involved in these celebrations.
Jamie Redknapp, you've not played all season, you've gone up to get the FA Cup. How did that feel?
It's hard to explain. It was a little bit embarrassing almost. The lads said they want me to do it, and it's such a nice gesture because I've not kicked the ball all season. But I've always felt part of the squad, and that, and just the effort they've put in today was just fantastic, and I'm just proud to be part of this squad.
You said to me at half time you were worried. How concerned were you?
Well, they play very well, Arsenal. They play fantastic, but when you've got a player like Michael Owen in his team, you've always got a chance, and his two goals are fantastic. You know, the first one was reminiscent of the England game he scored a few years ago, and then the second goal with his left foot, which is people say that his strongest side, was fantastic. I'm just proud, you know, the boys have done absolutely magnificent.
You said the lads, it was a bit embarrassing asking you to go up, but how emotional did you feel when you went up? Come on, be honest, Jamie.
I don't know how to explain it, but it just makes me feel good, you know. I've not played, but sometimes when you're not playing, it's a hard slog, but then it's just quite a gesture. I can't say any more than that. It's the nicest thing anyone's ever done, you know.
Go and enjoy your moment. Well done.
There's not a nicer young man in football than Jamie Redknapp. He's had a rotten time, and he deserves his moment with his teammates who have managed so well without him. Arsenal have departed, and their supporters as well. And leaving the stage to Liverpool and their anthem. They certainly haven't walked alone here. Final with a fantastic finale. Arsenal 1, Liverpool 2.